हेलो डियर चिल्ड्रेन, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द माइक्रोब्स एंड फ्यूल. ओके, एज यू नो माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर यूजफुल फॉर डिकम्पोजिशन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक सब्सटेंसेस. माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स कैन सर्वाइव एनरोबिकली, दैट मीन्स दिस एनरोबिक माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स और एनरोबिक ऑर्गेनिजम्स दे डिकम्पोज डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस. These substances are actually the waste substance for us, but those are very useful substance for microorganisms. Like the urban waste products, that is the waste which comes from the cities, the agricultural waste, industrial waste. So, the gaseous fuel can be obtained by the decomposition of these waste substance. Gaseous fuels, for example, the methane, it is a fuel which burns completely because it is saturated hydrocarbon. Ethanol is an alcohol and is a clean fuel. How we get ethanol? Ethanol is obtained by the fermentation of molasses as well as fermentation of different types of cellulose by the yeast. Okay, that name of the yeast is Saccharomyces cerevisiae, that you know, Saccharomyces yeast. Hydrogen gas is also a fuel. You know, hydrogen is a combustible gas and it can be produced with the help of electrolysis of water. So microorganisms can help us for photolysis of water. Some bacterias help for photoreduction. Photoreduction means helps for separating out the hydrogen, removing out the hydrogen from oxygen. So similar to fuels, various industrial chemicals are also produced through microbial process. So what are those chemicals? These are the various alcohols, acetone, organic acid, fatty acids, polysaccharides. These are the raw materials which are used in the chemical industries. Okay, so these raw materials are used for plastic as well as for some of the food products. Here some organism, that is the microbes, are shown. These microbes can act for naturally occurring and engineered microbes. These microbes can be engineered again for doing good work. Engineered means then their DNA can be changed for decomposition, more decomposition of the substance. Okay, as well as from these decomposed substance, what product can be obtained is the ethanol. So ethanol is added in the crude oil and we can use it as the biodiesel. This is a photograph of hydrolysis of water, that is photolysis, how water can be separated out by passing electric current. Okay, we can separate out hydrogen from water by passing electric current, but here instead of passing electric current we can photolyze the water with the help of microorganisms, and hydrogen gas can be formed or can be produced. This hydrogen gas can be stored in like a petrol pump, how we have, so we can have hydrogen gas pump also. So this hydrogen gas can be passed and stored into the tanks for further use as the fuel of vehicles or wherever the fuels require. Okay, see here, hydrogen gas. So we have to think of the substitute for different types of fuel like petrol, diesel. We can substitute, instead of petrol and diesel, we can substitute hydrogen gas. And now there is a great requirement of this type of renewable sources of energy. Okay, so we can think of the hydrogen gas pump. Next comes the biofuel. How biofuel can be obtained? We can collect different remains of plants and animals. Actually, the plants, whatever the biomass is there, this biomass can be taken in the form of dry or either the dead substance, or some of after the agriculture product, after the harvesting,
we can form cellulose. We get cellulose, that is a dry grass or dry leaves, plants, remains or leftover of the food grains, the husk, all those things contain cellulose. These cellulose can be digested with the help of microorganisms, and they can convert the cellulose to glucose, that is a type of sugar. Okay, and then this sugar can be fermented with the help of microorganisms, and we can produce biofuel. So this fuel is easily available and reliable. It is a reliable fuel for future. Okay, so fuels which are available in the solid is a coal, dung, crop residue. Liquid fuel is the vegetable oil, alcohol. Gaseous fuel is the gobar gas, coal gas. So these all are called as the biofuels. We are going to talk about the clean technology, that is the sewage management. Okay, whatever the sewage management or the garbage which is produced, tons of garbage is produced and is thrown, or either it is dumped in one place. After dumping this garbage, what happens? Microorganisms acts on it. Some of the enzymes are released from the microorganism's body. Sometimes these enzymes are very toxic, and these toxic enzymes mixed with water, rain water, as rain falls, and then it gets sipped into the earth's crust. When it gets sipped into the earth's crust, this toxic substance which is mixed with the water is passed into our, travel into our wells, tube wells. That means it is used as the drinking water. That means all these toxins enters our body and causes different types of diseases. Okay, so we have to think of cleaning, or think of cleaning this type of places where the garbage is dumped, or else use the microorganisms, as well as the place also will remain protected. The earth also will remain protected, and the toxic substance will not be added continuously into the earth's water, ground water. Okay, so the cleaning process, what we can do, here in the water, injection of microbes are injected in the water. Suppose if the water is polluted, then microbes are injected in the water. Microbes, they trap all the contaminants because they require to feed on them. They use it as their nutrients, and then they degrade the substance, past produce carbon dioxide, and water is released. Carbon dioxide is released and water is also formed. So biofuel production, see here the same thing what I have told you before, the biomass. This biomass contains cellulose. Cellulose can be converted to glucose with the help of microorganisms, and liquid fuel can be produced because of fermentation. Okay, and this fuel can be used for the vehicles as well as wherever it is required. The fuel, after burning, it gives out carbon dioxide, and carbon dioxide again can be used by plants. Landfilling sites, we are going to talk about the sites. Landfilling sites are degradable waste which comes from the urban areas in large quantity. Tons of waste is being produced, and this waste is collected from house to house or industries to industry, and then collected in an open land, on an open land. That open land is called as land filling sites. These land filling sites makes the soil pollution, adds the toxic substance to the soil. As I have told you, how it adds toxic substance to the soil, because of the action of microorganisms. Okay, see here the landfill. A large amount of waste is being carried by the truck by the carriers, and then it is brought on one place and dumped. After dumping it, either it is burned or either it is left just as it is, unobserved by any of the authorities. After that, when the rain falls, these landfills gets mixed with the rainwater. The enzymes which are there, microorganisms which are fed on it, many insects, they all get mixed with the water. Okay, this dirt gets mixed with the water and then it travels to the groundwater into our drinking water. Okay, even though our filtration plant at home is not able to separate out those toxic substances, so we have to think of some of the measures here. What measure we can think of is the landfill. Land is dug at a particular height under the ground, and this underground is being covered with the help of a plastic, or either it is sealed. Okay, and the garbage which is brought, this garbage is brought and dumped into this land. Okay, and then further layers of soil are added. Layers of garbage and the other layer of soil on it is added, and further it is made for the action. It is left for the action, further action of microorganisms on that garbage. As microorganisms act on that garbage, they produced methane gas. Okay, as well as after the production of methane gas, this methane gas is taken out from here through pipes, and then it can be supplied either in the villages or either in the factories, wherever it is required as fuel. Further, from that landfill, those degradable substances are now converted into compost. This compost is collected, okay, and then it is collected and then can be used for agriculture purpose as fertilizers. Okay, so such landfill sites are very, very important to be taken. It can take care of the environment, it can take care of the agriculture, as well as it can take care of the earth's crust, as it can keep the water also clean and pure. Okay, so best quality compost can be formed. So bioreactors are mixed at this place. Bioreactors means these are the microbes which react on the decomposed garbage. Okay, the garbage which is biodegradable. So only it is suggested that from household itself, separate out the biodegradable waste as well as the degradable or non-degradable waste, so that it becomes easy for making the compost. See here, the landfill, here what is done? A hole is dug, a big hole is dug in the ground, and then a thick plastic paper is laid down on the ground so that it breaks the contact. The garbage breaks the contact with the soil. Even though rain falls, this garbage substance is not mixed with the soil. And further, the garbage is added, brought from different places and dumped here on this plastic paper. Okay, and then microbes are added here so that they can act on the garbage and produced compost. See here the same picture from your textbook. You could see landfill, how the land is dug and then garbage is being put inside and then covered. Next is the injection. Wherever the ground water is there, and suppose the water is has contaminated, the water has contaminated, and then you can release out the microbes through injection into the groundwater, so that the water can be, microorganism can degrade the pollutants and we can get clear groundwater, that is clean water. Next is the sewage management. Sewage, as you know what sewage is, it is a waste which comes or carried by the help of the water. It can be from house to house, it can be from factories, and those substances, this sewage water, so dirty water that it contains a large amount of harmful microorganisms or pathogens. These pathogens can mixed with our drinking water, causing cholera, typhoid, and different types of other diseases. They also, this sewage water also decomposes just at the open place, and they can, it can release methane and carbon dioxide gas after decomposition. So let's think of this sewage water for decomposition and use it for the further purpose. Water can be cleaned by the action of microorganism, and this clean water can be recycled and used for some other purpose like agriculture, or wherever in the industry large quantity of water is used. Okay, so by the decomposition of this carbon compound, see how the dumping, the sewage water treatment plant it is. This plant is a sewage water treatment plant. So microbes are added in this plant, and these microbes decompose or destroys the harmful microorganisms, as well as they released out methane gas as and the carbon dioxide gas. Phenol oxidizing bacteria, they decompose the xenobiotic chemicals present in the sewage. Remember the name of the bacteria, phenol oxidizing bacteria. They decompose xenobiotic chemicals present in the sewage. Now these xenobiotic chemicals are the chemicals or the substance which are foreign to the environment. Foreign means new, as well as they are harmful hydrocarbons. Okay, so what are these xenobiotic substances? These can be the food additives, this can be the pesticides, this can be the carcinogens, drugs, medicines, your soap, detergent, all those things are included in these xenobiotic chemicals. So sewage management in villages, domestically what we do, we decompose this sewage just nearby to our house. We dug a hole or a soap pit and decompose this sewage in the form of, or either in the biogas plant. But in cities, this sewage needs to be carried to the processing unit and acted upon by microbial process. Microbes which can decompose these substances as well as destroys the pathogens of cholera, typhoid, and other diseases. They are mixed with the sewage water, and they release out methane and carbon dioxide gas after they decompose the substance. And after decomposition of carbon compounds which are present in the sewage, phenol oxidizing bacteria acts on it for decomposition of xenobiotic chemicals which are present in the sewage. Here, this is also a plant, sewage management plant. So the sludge, that is a slurry which is very dirty water which is been carried away, the pollutants which are carried away by the water from the industries, from domestic waste. So this sludge is allowed to settle down, and after when it settles down, heavy particles are collected and used as fertilizers, and the water which is above that sludge, that water is collected for microbial treatment, which can be environment safe. These microbes are used for bioremediation. Bioremediation means these microbes helps for breaking down of pollutants. Okay, so bioremediation means microbes which are used for breaking down of environmental pollutants. Okay, use of microbes for breaking down of environmental pollutants in order to clean the polluted sites. So that process is called as bioremediation. Okay, till here it is, understand it, read the lesson till here, whatever we have studied. Further a lot part is there, and very important for our day-to-day life to keep our earth clean and environment also to be maintained clean.